So we're featuring another episode with Ted Lasso today. And this is one of my favorite episodes about being curious. And before I get into that, I want to talk about my own kind of adventures around being curious. When I was working for the Philadelphia YMCA, my boss suggested to me that I take a Dale Carnegie course, the same course that he took when he was my age. And I took the course, and every week we'd have a speaking engagement. But one of the things that we learned during the course is being a better listener, to talk less and learn more. And at some point, we used to call that daling people to death, daling them to death, because we'd go someplace and we just practice listening, listening, listening. And sometimes I've been really successful at that, and other times I've totally failed because I probably was too interested in talking about something that I knew versus trying to learn from the person. So I want to tee up this Ted Lasso piece. This is where his Ted Lasso's boss, his husband, who getting a divorce, was wanting to still be involved with the football team, the soccer team. And what happened was she didn't want him involved at all anymore. And so they're at a bar, and Ted and the other owner, the man, challenges Ted to a dart game. Didn't ask a lot of questions, just tell him to challenge him to the game. So I'd love for you to watch this clip.
Mate, what do I need to win?
2 triple 20s and a bullseye.
Good luck.
You know, Rupert, guys have underestimated me my entire life. And for years, I never understood why. It used to really bother me. But then one day, I was driving my little boy to school, and I saw this quote by Walt Whitman. It was painted on the wall there. It said, "Be curious, not judgmental." And I like that. So I get back in my car, and I'm driving to work, and all of a sudden, it hits me. All them fellas that used to belittle me, not a single one of them were curious. You know, they thought they had everything all figured out, and so they judged everything, and they judged everyone. And I realized that they're underestimating me. Who I was had nothing to do with it. Because if they were curious, they would ask questions. You know? Questions like, "Have you played a lot of darts, Ted?" Which I would have answered, "Yes, sir." Every Sunday afternoon at a sports bar with my father from age 10 until I was 16 when he passed away. Barbecue sauce.
So as you can see, if there was only a few questions asked that the other owner wouldn't have challenged Ted probably to a dart game, which he lost. So I had a recent story this past weekend going to buy a car. And what I did was I was really interested in the person that was selling the car to me, the car salesman. And rather than ask a lot of questions about the car, I really wanted to learn about him. And I found out that his wife was from Kiev. I found out that he was in the Air Force for 18 years, that he had been with this company for about the same time, about 18 years. And what that did was it built up a lot of trust, at least for me, feeling like what this gentleman was going to sell me, he was going to be honest, and I could trust him. And I made the decision to buy the car primarily because, A, I liked the car, but also because I trusted the person selling it. I wouldn't have probably felt like that if I didn't learn a lot about him. So I'd love to hear your stories about trust, about being curious, and what you've learned through your careers, for what it's worth.